I want to introduce the group to you. This is the quartet that we have been touring Europe with, and I'm very pleased personally and musically to have them with me. First of all, on bass from Copenhagen, Niels Kornhorstedt Pedersen. And on drums from London, England, Mr. Martin Drew. From Göteborg, Sweden, very talented guitarist, Ulf Backenbrees. Today we're not going to do anything that spectacular, but we just want to talk to you about jazz and our approach to jazz, and how we try to put the quartet together in such a way that it becomes one unit, so that we breathe together, we think together, and we play together.
E vai ser um vídeo que vamos ter entre o Nesca e o Catedrano, de montar como ele construiu essa música, como ele construiu esse quarteto, a fim de Santiago, uma solidité, de maneira d'essayer de respirar ensemble, de penser a mesma coisa, de maneira que não é plus que um som. Então, é cette approche-là que vai ser.
First and foremost, I was asked a question the other night by a gentleman, a pianist. He wanted to know how I was able to make notes sound differently as I played. And I tried to explain it to him so that it was the same as speech. You don't speak in a monotone, but your speech is the best. And I tried to play that.
Piece
that was written by Count Basie, and I'm going to try and show you how I control trio, or try to control the quartet, not trying to control the quartet, with a single line, despite them listening to the depth of my playing.
Il va prendre l'exemple sur une composition de Count Basie. Il va jouer une ligne mélodique très simple et va essayer de vous montrer comment il arrive à contrôler le quartet pour exprimer cette musique.
Same density, the same intensity throughout.
Si vous avez bien fait attention à cette ligne, vous avez vu qu'elle garde toujours la même intensité.
Now I'm going to increase the impetus, as we say, of the groove by playing with a little more intensity on the second chorus.
Là, dans le deuxième chorus, il va essayer de demander cette intensité, de provoquer le monde.
Thank you. Teach at York University in Toronto. When you play in a group, the most important thing is you listen. You listen intently to what is going on behind you.
Il enseigne à l'Université de Toronto et ce qu'il dit toujours à tous les gens qui jouent dans un groupe, le plus important c'est d'écouter, afin justement de travailler, de se focaliser sur l'intensité, sur les variations de l'intensité.
You notice at times that Martin played brushes. Other times he used the sticks, as we say, wood. And when I really want the intensity, I ask for wood. And I do it by the way I play. And Niels acts the same way. When he hears my notes get deeper, his notes get deeper. Would you show him the difference in the two types of playing, Niels? Play the way you would play the first chorus and then say one of the. As Count Basie proved over all his years of playing. But there are more intense players, I'm supposed to be one of them, that uses a much more intense way of playing at times, but not all of the time, just some of the time. So I'd like to do a blues now, and this is the same kind of feeling, but it's a much deeper feeling, because we start into the blues with a heavy feeling.
Là, il vous a donné un exemple de ce que le camp de a fait toute sa vie, c'est-à-dire qu'on peut exprimer l'intensité avec très très peu de notes. Il n'y a pas de rapport entre l'intensité et la quantité de notes. Et il y a une chose très bonne, il a dit, maintenant chacun a sa personnalité. Je suis supposé par réputation être quelqu'un pour exprimer l'intensité, mais beaucoup de notes. Alors il va essayer de jouer un blues à sa manière. Mais toujours pareil, vous comprenez l'intensité. Et surtout le rapport qu'il y a, ils n'ont même pas besoin de se regarder, simplement par la manière dont il contrôle ses phrases, dont il contrôle l'intensité et non pas le débit, tout le quartet joue au même jeu.
Started at the very beginning and remained right through. And when the guitar solo came up, I started playing what I call figures behind groove with Martin, just to give it like a big band feel, you know, to give it a shout.
I hope you all realize that being in a rhythm section like this is really a privilege, because you have something to play against. Not in a negative way, but in a very, very positive way. I mean, all the energy that Oscar is talking about that we can come up with, well, if he wasn't there, we wouldn't have anything to play. So it's really something where, like you mentioned earlier, that you breathe together, you play together. If we don't do that, it doesn't work. Well, I just wanted to make that point.
Pour une section rythmique, c'est un formidable challenge parce que grâce à Oscar, ils ont quelque chose contre quoi jouer. Mais pas au sens négatif, au sens positif. Il y a vraiment un challenge à relever. Et c'est encore une fois la manière dont joue Oscar, justement.
This is going into the Brazilian type thing. I'm going to play this because I think that it has the same kind of excitement and intensity, but it retains the Brazilian feel. It's an original of mine. It's called Tranquilla, and I wrote this a couple of years ago, but you'll notice that the rhythm is very sympathetic to what I do, but as I increase, the rhythm increases. Please note. Thank you. Control this instrument from here, not just from here, but from here, and not only from there, but from here. And I see many pianists today, and I've seen many pianists that play this way. What we call flat fingers. I see other pianists that play this way. Which I call flying fingers. The difference is, if I want to play something, the idea is to keep my fingers close to the keyboard. If my hand is up here, and I'm playing something at this tempo, it's very hard to go back down there in time. But if you keep your fingers close to the keys, and my teacher taught me to bend my fingers, not flat fingers, bend them. Because that way I can control the tone. When you're practicing, how many pianists do we have here?
Combien de pianistes?
When you're practicing, whenever you're practicing, I'll give you a couple of quick exercises that you can do to help yourselves. When you practice, start on C, G and F. Keep that going. Maintain the tone. And you should not have to be staring at your hands like this to make sure that they won't move. You should be able to look away. The other thing to strengthen your hands is to play a C with your thumb, an E with your second finger, and a G with your third finger. And then trill these two. Has anyone tried that? Someone like to know? It'll build the strength up in here. It'll give you better tone at the end. It's something I've done before, so I've worked at, and I still do it. But if you listen to me, I want you to listen to the what I call the depth of tone.
Voilà, moi que je n'ai pas traduit depuis tout à l'heure, et monsieur m'a fait remarquer, parce qu'en français, j'ai insisté dessus, mais pas avec le mot clair, parce qu'on n'y fait jamais assez attention. Il y a un mot qu'il emploie sans arrêt, c'est tone and depth of tone. Il parle de la sonorité et de la profondeur de la sonorité. Et tous ces exercices et toute sa musique, tout son jeu de pianiste est basé sur ça. Il veut sans arrêt contrôler sa sonorité, le son, pas seulement les notes.
All right. I'm just going to play a series of lines. Did anyone hear the tone change?
Est-ce que vous avez entendu des changements, de sonorité?
Yes.
You must have control of the tone at all times. If you lose control of it, you lose control of the group.
Si vous perdez le contrôle de la sonorité, vous perdez le contrôle du corps.
And let's play a tune, another composition of mine that I wrote many years ago. And it's a very simple composition. It's called Wheatland. And I'd like you to listen to the kind of tonal approach I take to the piano, okay?
Thank you.
call conversations in the quartet in which we talk to each other with the instruments. And we're going to give you an illustration of that right now by doing another tune by Neil Hefti. This is Cute, and it features our percussionist, Marty Pate.
Thank you.
faster than jazz, meaning he decided to get into it. Jazz is a very, very serious art form, and it can only be increased by the honest efforts of players like yourself.
J'espère que la manière de tout ce que nous avons montré va vous aider chacun dans votre instrument. Et la dernière phrase, il a surtout insisté sur le fait à savoir que le jazz, contrairement à ce que à certaines apparences, c'est une forme d'art très, très, très sérieuse. Et donc il vous encourage à vraiment travailler et surtout vous tous, puisque nous sommes les musiciens actuels, c'est à nous tous de continuer cette forme-là.
Feeling fancy free, and I'm not alone. I got company, everything's okay. The livelong day.